Welcome back to our English class. In our previous class, we revised poems called what? The cow, books, and one thing at a time. Okay? So today we are going to revise lessons. And the lesson we are going to revise is the clever robin. See here? So it was a story about a pretty young hen and a cunning fox. The story was about a pretty young hen and a cunning fox. Pretty hen's name was Hilda. Hilda was what kind of a hen? She was a very pretty young hen. Her body was covered with soft red feathers. She lived in a small house where near the river. One day, Hilda, the pretty young hen, was going to the market. She wanted to buy grain. She wanted to buy grains. Hen eats what? Grains. Billy was a cunning fox. He saw the healthy hen. Hen was not only pretty, she was healthy too. And Billy was a cunning fox. He was a very cunning fox. His mouth started watering. He thought to himself, "This healthy hen can make a tasty meal for me and my family." So this cunning fox wanted to eat this pretty young hen. So he thought that this healthy hen can make a tasty meal for me and my family. Willy ran home. He told his wife, Velma. Willy's wife's name was what? Velma. He told Velma to boil some water in pot. Now Velma asked Willy, "Why do you want to boil water?" Willy says, "Today I will prepare a tasty meal for you and our children." When Velma asks Willy why should she boil water, then Willy answers her that, "Today I will prepare a tasty meal for you and our children." Then Velma asks again, "What are you making for lunch?" Willy says, "It's a surprise. You just boil some water." Velma says, "Okay, I will keep the pot of boiling water ready." Then Willy left house with a big sack. He hid behind a tree and waited for the hen to return from the market. Willy left the house with what? With a big sack. He hid behind a tree and waited for the hen. He waited for Hilda to return from the market. She had went to market to buy what? Grains. Then, as Hilda passed by the tree, Willy caught her and put her in the sack. As soon as Hilda was passing the tree, what happened? Willy caught her. Willy caught Hilda and put Hilda in the sack. Ronnie, the clever robin. Who was Ronnie? Ronnie was a clever robin. The clever robin saw Willy catch Hilda. Ronnie, the clever robin, saw Willy catch Hilda. Willy is a cunning fox. Hilda is a pretty young, healthy hen. Hilda and Ronnie were best friends. He decided to help his friend. Ronnie decided to help his friend, Hilda. He thought of a plan. Ronnie was a clever robin. So, he thought of a plan. See here, this is Willy. And this is Ronnie. Who is there in this sack? Hilda, pretty young, healthy hen. Who has been caught by Willy. Ronnie flew and stood before Willy. He started hopping on one leg. Willy thought that Ronnie had hurt his leg. Willy said to himself, "I must have this robin for my meal too." Ronnie flew and stood before Willy to trick it. He started hopping on one leg. Who? Ronnie started hopping on one leg. Willy thought that Ronnie had hurt his leg. Willy said to himself, "I must have this robin for my meal too." Now, Willy was planning to eat Ronnie too. He kept the sack under a tree and ran after Ronnie through narrow roads. He kept the sack under a tree and ran after Ronnie through narrow roads. He kept the sack where? Under the tree and ran after Ronnie through narrow roads, through small roads. Ronnie thought, what a foolish fox he is. Ronnie thought to himself, what a foolish fox he is. Then see, let's see what happens. Now Ronnie was very clever. He hopped and hopped and led the fox away from the tree. Ronnie was acting like he has hurt his leg, but in reality he was all okay. So Ronnie hopped and led the fox away from the tree. Hilda slowly came out of the sack. As soon as Willie followed Ronnie through narrow roads, Hilda slowly came out of the sack. She filled the sack with stones and ran away. Hilda did what? She filled the sack with stones and she ran away. When enough time had passed, Ronnie was sure that Hilda must have escaped and reached home. So he flew away. Willie was disappointed. He went back to the tree. He picked up the sack and went home. When enough time had passed, Ronnie was sure that Hilda must have escaped from the sack and she must have reached home. So Ronnie flew away. Willie was disappointed that he couldn't catch Ronnie. He went back to the tree. Willie went back to the tree. He picked up the sack thinking Hilda is in it and he went home. Velma. Who is Velma? Willie's wife. What have you brought for us? Willie says, a healthy, big and fat hen for you, me and our children. Now please help me empty the sack. Willie says, I have brought a healthy, big, fat hen for you, me and our children. Now please help me empty this sack. Velma, are you sure you got a hen? I find the sack very heavy. Velma asks Willie, are you sure you got a hen? I am finding the sack very heavy. Willie and Velma turned the sack upside down over the pot of boiling water. They did what? They turned the sack upside down like this over the boiling hot water. The heavy stone fell into the pot. The boiling water splashed all around like this. They not only had to go without food, but also got burned on their faces and hands. So, this is how the clever robin Ronnie rescued and helped his friend Hilda. So did you learn some good things about friendship, kids? So now let's move to the next lesson. Next lesson is about unity. We have always heard that unity is strength, but today we will revise a small lesson which will tell us why unity is strength. Why we always say that unity is strength. See, once upon a time there was a flock of doves that flew in search of food to a faraway place. They were led by their king. Once upon, there was a flock of doves. See here, flock, collective noun, group of doves, flock. There was a flock of doves, group of doves that flew in search of food to a faraway place. As we know, birds flew Birds fly in the search of food everywhere. So here also there was a flock of doves that was in search of food. So they flew to a far away place. They were led by their king. There was a king into this flock. One day they had flown a long distance and were very tired. The king dove encouraged them to fly a little further. The youngest dove saw some rice scattered on the ground beneath a big banyan tree. Young dove, I can see some rice beneath that tree. Let us go there. Young dove says, I can see some rice beneath that tree. Let us go there. They were all very hungry. After flying so much, they got very hungry. They were all very hungry. So they all landed and began to eat that rice. Suddenly, a net fell over them. Suddenly, what happened? A net fell over them. They were all trapped. They were all trapped in that net. They saw a hunter approaching them with a huge club. They saw a hunter coming towards them, approaching them with a huge club. Young dove says, oh my God, a hunter is coming to catch us. King dove says, yes, we have been trapped by the hunter. Dove one says, what do we do now? King dove says, we should have thought of it earlier before landing here. Dove 2 says, yes, king, we should have thought that rice could possibly not come on its own under a tree. The doves desperately fluttered their wings and tried to get out. But to no avail, there was no use of fluttering their wings. So, the king dove was very smart, very clever. So, he thought of a plan. He says, all of you come down. I have an idea. There is a great strength in unity. You all follow my instructions. So, king is telling other birds that, all of you come down. Don't worry, I have an idea. There is a great strength in unity. You all follow my instruction. Do as I say. All doves say, yes, king, we shall follow your command. King dove, now listen to me carefully. Each one of you pick up a portion of net. When I say go, we fly up together carrying the net with us. All doves, we all are ready, king. King dove says, on your mark, get set, go. The doves flew up with the net. The hunter looked up in astonishment. He get astonished. The hunter looked very astonished. Hunter, oh no, my prey has gone. Oh no, my prey has gone. I will have to go hungry today. My net has gone too. He started cursing himself. He tried to follow them, but the birds were flying high over the hills and the valleys. They flew to a hill near a city of temples where a mouse lived. He was a faithful friend of the king dove. Who was a faithful friend of the king dove? A mouse which was living near a city of temples. When the mouse heard the loud noise of their approach, he went into hiding. King dove gently called out to him. King dove says, oh mouse, I am your friend, the king dove. The mouse slowly appeared from his hiding place. He was surprised to see them in the net. Mouse, oh king, I welcome you to my land, but who did this to you? How can I help you? King dove says, we were trapped by a hunter. I request you to call your friends to gnaw at the net and set us free. Gnaw means chewing. The mouse immediately called his friends. Mouse, friends, start your work. Let us free the king. King Dove says, not me first. Kindly free my subjects first and then me. The King Dove says, not me first. Kindly free my subjects first and then me. Mouse says, O noble king, we shall do as you say. All the mice began to bite the net and one by one all the doves were freed, including the king dove. All doves say, thank you for setting us free. All doves say this to all whom? Mouse and other mice. All doves, thank you for setting us free. King dove, thanks, my dear friends. Thereafter, they all flew away together, united in their strength. So, this story tells us about what unity is, strength. So, we have revised two lessons today. So, kids, this is enough for today's class. We will revise other lessons in next class. Till then, study well and take care.